Graduands, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the academic procession is about to commence. Would you all please stand and remain standing until after the national anthem has been sung? Thank you.
Distinguished guests, graduands, ladies and gentlemen, I acknowledge the traditional owners of the land, the Larrakia people, on which this ceremony is taking place. As Chancellor of the Charles Darwin University, I've attended many graduation ceremonies and always feel very privileged to be part of such a special occasion. Graduation is a significant milestone for graduands and their families. All study is demanding, as I'm sure all graduands have already discovered. It can be challenging, fitting study around work and family commitments and social activities. so completing your studies is enormously satisfying. I congratulate you on your achievement. May I also express my sincere appreciation to the staff of this university for assisting you on your learning journey and for continuing to make this university a place of excellence and fine achievements. Today is your day to remember, to celebrate and cherish. You have earned it, and I wish you a wonderful and joyful day of celebration. Thank you.
Today's occasional address will be delivered by Ms. Lisa Paul, who is Secretary of the Commonwealth Department of Education. Lisa has been a Chief Executive for 10 years across three different secretary roles, these being the Department of Education, Science and Training, the Department of Education, Employment and Workplace Relations, and her current role, which she has held since 2013. She was made an Officer of the Order of Australia in 2011 for distinguished service to public service leadership in key policy and program implementation, and in the same year received the Australian Chartered Accountants Federal Government Leader of the Year Award. In 2003, Lisa was awarded a Public Service Medal for her role as leading the Australian Government's domestic response to the Bali bombings. Lisa is a National Fellow of the Institute of Public Administration Australia, a Fellow of the Australian Council for Educational Leaders, a Fellow of the Australian Institute of Management, an Australian National University Public Policy Fellow, a member of the Australian Institute of Company Directors, and a member of Chief Executive Women. Graduands, ladies and gentlemen, would you please give a hearty Darwin welcome to Ms. Lisa Paul.
Thank you, Vice-Chancellor, for your very kind introduction. I acknowledge the traditional owners of the land that we meet on today, the Larrakia people, and in a spirit of reconciliation, pay my respects to elders past and present. And in particular, I pay my respects to Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people here, many of whom I'm sure are elders. Well, congratulations to everyone graduating today. You should feel really, really proud. Congratulations to family and friends who are here for your support. Congratulations to the Chancellor, the Vice-Chancellor, and all the CDU faculty. Without you, this day would simply not be possible. I invite you to sit back, relax, stretch time, savour this time. I can guarantee that you will remember this day for your whole life. You will remember it with gratitude, with happiness, and with enormous pride. So enjoy this moment and reflect. Reflect on everything you have achieved, which has all culminated in today's celebration. You've worked hard. You're graduating from a university which is committed to helping you change your world and to change the world. Many of you are the first in your family to go to a university. That's an amazing achievement. Many of you have studied later in life, juggling families and jobs as well as your studies. And many of you have studied online, one of the largest proportions of any university. Your hard work, combined with your own talent, and CDU's excellent teaching has produced your achievement. You've had the privilege of attending a university which is ranked in the top 2% of universities in the world and within the top 100 universities aged less than 50 years old. A university that proudly educates four times more Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people than the average university. In the last 10 years, CDU has put itself on the map as a high-quality university to rival any. And CDU is vital to Australia's future through the success of Northern Australia. Being from CDU will definitely open doors for you. Your qualification is a passport to opportunity. I can vouch for the value of a qualification from CDU because I'm the Chief Executive of the Federal Government Department of Education. This includes responsibilities for all of Australia's universities and for international students and for research. It's a $32 billion a year global enterprise. I'm proud of setting high standards for Australian universities because you benefit. In August, my staff attended your open day. Future students and their parents were worried about help loans in the face of the government's proposed changes to higher education. I can promise that HEX help will stay. Like you, future students will not have to pay a cent up front until they earn a good wage, and vocational students would not have to pay loan fees. About 80,000 more students would receive some financial support for their course fees, including those studying higher education diplomas and associate degrees. My department touches the lives of every Australian in a positive way and is vital for Australia's future, be it through childcare, schools, or higher education. It's a great job and a privilege every day to run the Federal Government Department of Education. But I can still remember my own graduation day with pride. Feeling pride was a little unexpected in my case, because I'd not actually been the most diligent student. In fact, I spent a lot of my time in the Australian National University bar. I hung out with mates, made lifelong friends, worked a lot part-time, and every now and again I actually studied. But I did learn how to think critically, how to frame a logical argument and put a case. I studied subjects I'm still passionate about, and graduated with pride with a Bachelor of Arts with honours. Above all, I remember my graduation day being a happy day. So I thought I would talk to you about happiness, about what the research says it actually is and how you get it and keep it. The research is in the area of positive psychology, you might have heard about this in books called Flourish and Learned Optimism by Professor Martin Seligman, or perhaps on the Happiness Show on the ABC. The research says there are five essential ingredients for happiness for every one of us. The first is positive emotion, being optimistic rather than pessimistic, being a glass half full person. This can be hard sometimes. But even if you're a pessimist, the research says you can learn to look on the bright side. For example, it says if you write down three things each day that were good and why, optimism will creep up on you. The second ingredient for a happy life is to be in flow. This means to lose yourself in what you're doing right now, to be in the moment. We are usually most in flow, believe it or not, at work. Work is good for happiness. But you can be in flow playing sport, talking to friends, or just being right here in the present moment enjoying this special day. The third ingredient for a happy life is having good relationships. All of you whose family and friends are celebrating with you today know the importance of relationships with other people. We support each other. We need love in our lives. The fourth essential ingredient is finding meaning. This means working for a cause bigger than you. It means helping other people, really making a difference, caring about something big. I'll give you an example from my own life. In October 2002, terrorists bombed Kuta Beach in Bali, and 88 Australians were killed and many more injured, with many being badly burned. I had the privilege of leading the federal government's domestic response to the Bali bombings. We helped families travel to Bali or travel here to Darwin to visit loved ones flown into Royal Darwin Hospital. We paid for their travel, we laid on support, and we kept everyone informed. It was sad, important work, and it was an honour. It definitely had meaning. The last ingredient is accomplishment, getting stuff done, achieving. Well, we are celebrating your accomplishments today. But guess what? Having stuff, fast cars, techie toys, etc., does not make you much happier. Stuff is not a key ingredient. As a rabbi once said, happiness is not having what you want, but wanting what you have. So think about it. I'm lucky I can get all those essential ingredients for happiness just from the work I do every day. But my career started almost accidentally. I just randomly sat an entry test for the public service after graduating. The person next to me taking the test fell asleep, so I figured I was in with a chance. I passed the test and I was instantly hooked on the difference I could make to the lives of Australians and others like international students. Every year, my department of about 1,800 people takes in just over 20 really smart graduates. So I emailed them and said, I'm doing a speech to CDU graduates. What advice would you give them? Here's what some of my own graduates offer to you. Chris said, use the opportunity your education has afforded you to serve others. Cherish your education because it has empowered you. It has shaped who you are and what you will become, whether you like it or not, or whether you realise it or not. Steph said, in a world that is changing and moving so fast, the only thing you can be sure about is you. Stay true to yourself, especially in your work life, through your aspirations, the decisions you make, the relationships you form, and giving the best you can. I think they are smart, and they're actually describing a path to happiness. Enjoy your most happy day. I pay full tribute to you and to your great university. I wish you all success and happiness. Thank you.
Lisa Paul, thank you for the acknowledgement that you have just given to our students and to Charles Darwin University. Thank you also for touching on an aspect of a government policy that's most important as far as our students are concerned. Thank you for being another person who, like myself, has to acknowledge that they were not always the most diligent of students. And finally, thank you for the advice that you have given on the aspect of the importance of happiness. Please, ladies and gentlemen, graduates, let us once again thank Lisa Paul, Secretary of the Commonwealth Department of Education. Graduates, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this morning's musical presentation will be Read All About It, performed by Zoe Nankerville.
But your body, your tongue, got a lifetime stuck in silence, afraid you'll say something wrong. If no one ever hears it, how we gonna learn your song? So come on, come on, come on, come on. You got a heart as loud as lions, so why let your voice be tame? Baby, we're a little different, there's no need to be ashamed. Got the light to fight the shadow, stop hiding it away. Come on, come on, I neighbors while we sing away the blues, making sure that we remember, yeah, cause we all matter too. If the truth has been forbidden, then we're breaking all the rules. Come on, come on, come on, come on, let's get the TV and the radio to play our tune again. It's about time we got some airplay of our versions of events, and there's no need to be afraid. I will sing with you, my friend. Come on, come on. All I wanna sing, I wanna shout, I wanna scream till the words dry out.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, would you join with me in again expressing our thanks to Zoe Nankerville. And now we move to the conferring of the awards. Vice Chancellor.
Would all the graduands please rise? Chancellor, as the Vice-Chancellor of Charles Darwin University, I submit to you candidates for awards of Charles Darwin University as listed in the graduation program. I certify that those listed have satisfied the requirements for the award of those degrees, diplomas and certificates.
As Chancellor of Charles Darwin University, I hereby admit to their respective awards the candidates whose names appear in the graduation program. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, our graduates. Graduates may now resume their seats.
I now call upon the Pro Vice Chancellor of the Faculty of Engineering, Health, Science and the Environment to present graduates from that faculty.
Chancellor, distinguished guests, family, friends, graduates, fellow staff, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to be here today to celebrate the achievements of the graduating higher education students from programs in the Faculty of Engineering, Health Science and the Environment. We work hard to prepare students for careers designed to meet the needs of employers and the community. Across our campuses, we are proud to provide opportunities in areas spanning science, nursing, midwifery, pharmacy, psychology, exercise and sports science, engineering, information technologies, environmental sciences, and social work, amongst others. Many of our programs are professionally accredited, and most are available both internally and externally to cater for the diverse needs of our student population. Our students gain a wealth of experience during their time with us, including the opportunity to do placements at a range of locations, both in Australia and overseas, to work in remote areas and on real-world problems. Some also have the opportunity to engage in our world-class research programs. We really hope our graduates leave CDU with the skills and experience required to take them on their next journey. Today, we are celebrating the successes of our graduates, a time to reflect on what you have achieved and where you might be going next. This time of graduation is likely one of mixed emotions for you all. Joy and relief that your efforts have finally been rewarded and that those hours spent slaving over the books have finally paid off, but also regret that a phase of your life is coming to an end, and perhaps fear or trepidation that you don't know what's around the next corner. But hopefully, this is just one step in your learning journey, and I do hope that some of you might consider returning to CDU in the future to further your studies. I would like to offer my heartfelt congratulations to all the graduates this morning. This is an incredibly important milestone in your careers, and I hope the programs you have successfully completed will serve you well in the next phase of your lives. To family and friends, I also offer my congratulations, and I share your pride in the achievements of the graduates and acknowledge the important part you have played in their success. Chancellor, in my capacity as Pro Vice Chancellor of the Faculty of Engineering, Health, Science and the Environment, I present to you for the degree of Diploma of Engineering, John William Connolly. And Chancellor, Tatiana Maltseva. For the Bachelor of Behavioural Science, Keisha Bia Avalinosa. Miriam Densio. Jana Maria Donaldson. Melanie Marie Moore. Sonia Marie Skews. Maria Jocelyn Thompson.
And Chancellor Susan Elizabeth Ride. For the Bachelor of Biomedical Science, Jemima Amy Pearl Bishop. For the Bachelor of Engineering, Binul Tom Baby. Sebastian Iravaran. Ahmad Mazloum. Jonathan Orozco Monyos. For the Bachelor of Engineering Co-op, Geethan Barden. Yosifa Margarita Da Costa Chong. Kenneth Emmanuel Kardigama. And Chancellor Josiah Poole. For the Bachelor of Engineering Science, Kingsley Ebleeb. For the Bachelor of Environmental Science, Andrew Trigov Barons. Michelle Denise Cowald. Marissa Jane Stone. Jason Henry Toms. And Chancellor Katie Wanda Youngman. For the Bachelor of Environmental Science, Environmental Management, Aaron Timothy Kevin Brown. Sonia Therese Lovegrove. Expedito Bello. And Chancellor Bang Bang Ari Wibowo. For the Bachelor of Exercise and Sports Science, Bridie Dugan. Catherine Elizabeth Ferris. Rachel Carolyn Fox. And Chancellor Erin Gowing. For the Bachelor of Humanitarian and Community Studies, Michael Bol Dow. Wayne Robert Dillon. Festus Osagi Oko. Janine Ann Sims. And Chancellor Zoe Stewart. For the Bachelor of Information Technology, Mohammed Hassanul Banna. Abdul Basid. Edmar De La Cruz. Sachin Gamba. Mustafa Hamadi. Stephen Mills. C. Tien Nguyen. Best Oghal Okwa. Lalit Kumar Pant. James Robert Wyatt. And Chancellor Kai Zen. For the Bachelor of Information Technology, Co-op, Jason Lay. And Chancellor, Brendan Sujana. For the Bachelor of Medical Laboratory Science, Nicole Corinna Brenner. For the Bachelor of Nursing, Camille Dorothy Analazark. Marissa Ruth Berendina. Jasmine Canlas. Brenda Churai Shikara. Amanda Joy Cooper. Danielle Sire Crisafulli. Yeah. Eric Duran. Elizabeth Gabrielle Ellis. Amanda Jane Fenwick. Rex Ian Fernandez. Marie Fontanilla. Manisha Gutam Shalagain. Marlon Gillimack. Priya Ragni Goundon. Leonila Regala Harrison. Tisad Jabate. Francis Wing Ying Lee. Rella Algiojo Lisserald. Samuel Warui Makaki. Barbara Malhamvana. Edward Maywire. Davian Tiina Munro. Anna Catazzo. Ebony Jane Pedretti. Sally-Ann Pridham. Preeti Purnam. Cleo Jane Richardson. Leontina Sashalaru. And Chancellor Luis Sanchez Recrejo. For the Bachelor of Pharmacy, John Abdul-Malik. And Chancellor Anne Vu Dion. For the Bachelor of Social Work, Irini Kambarakis. And Chancellor Rhiannon Courtney Smith. For the Bachelor of Engineering Co-op with Second Class Honours, Division B, Shello Marie Alvaran. And Chancellor Cordelia Mack. The Bachelor of Social Work with Second Class Honours, Division A, Sarah Grace Sarmiento. For the Bachelor of Engineering Co-op with First Class Honours, Yanni Lolias. For the Bachelor of Science with First Class Honours, Rhiannon Louise Moore. And Chancellor Guillaume Roque Piwi. For the Graduate Diploma in Nursing, Bhikkhu Paruvamutil Abraham. Oluwakimi Omambini Adigun. Rosaline Omemwumi Olusoji. Nadine Tinsley. And Chancellor Mary Ann Tiris. For the Master of Engineering, Jirong Liu. Lachiraju Parisharala. And Chancellor Muhammad Adil Silat. For the Master of Health Practice, Nurse Practitioner, Precious Mapindia. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Engineering, Health Science and the Environment.
The Director of Menzies School of Health Research to present graduates from their faculty.
Chancellor, I'd like to acknowledge the Larrakia people and pay my respects to their elders past and present. Chancellor, Menzies is headquartered right here in Darwin. We are Australia's leader in Indigenous and tropical health research and a key partner of Charles Darwin University. We undertake research aiming to make a difference in the lives of people in the Northern Territory and across the Asian region. We want the impact of our work to be measurable, substantial, and sustainable. I'd like to mention three highlights of our work in 2014. In the last month, we published the results of a Northern Territory-based study in The Lancet, one of the world's leading medical journals. In this work, we addressed the problem of skin sores, which are estimated to affect the health of 110 million children globally, and are particularly alarmingly prevalent amongst Aboriginal children in remote communities. If these problems are treated poorly, they can have long-lasting and devastating effects on health. As we often do, we sought to do a practical, real-world study. Current treatment involves the use of regular, painful, not particularly appetizing, intramuscular injections of antibiotics. Not surprisingly, children are reluctant to turn up for their treatment courses. We undertook a trial where we compared newer oral medications against the intramuscular injections and showed that this treatment was at least equal to that of the usual treatment using the painful, unwelcome intramuscular antibiotics. This research will have major and fundamental implications for the treatment of this problem in Australia and worldwide. This morning, Chancellor, I woke up at 5:30 and 7 minutes later received the first of a multitude of emails from staff, because today the National Health and Medical Research Council announced its Australian funding round successes. Each year, there are now approximately 5,000 grants submitted to the National Competitive Grant Funding Scheme, and this year the success rate for all universities and medical research institutes was the alarmingly low 15% of all of those grants. I'm quite happy to say that the email I received at 5:37 made a rather good start to my own day, but I won't focus on that. I can say that Menzies was successful today in receiving more than $12 million worth of funding for research to be undertaken in the Northern Territory, and there are two particular highlights. The first was that we've received a $2.5 million grant for a National Centre of Research Excellence to address the very significant problem of middle ear infection in Aboriginal children. As you're aware, Chancellor, this affects up to 90% of Aboriginal children before the age of one in remote communities and directly impacts on educational attainment for children in these communities. A second National Centre of Research Excellence received was one to improve the quality of healthcare delivery in primary care general practices across the country, both for Aboriginal and non-Aboriginal people across the country. One of the key players in that Centre for Research Excellence, Dr. Nicole Percival, is receiving her PhD today. These are just some examples of the work we do. Obviously, also, we're committed to education and training future researchers. Students who work with us play a vital role in all of our research. We will be presenting some master's students this morning, and I also want to note and congratulate our two PhD students who will be awarded their PhD today, Dr. Anita DiPrano for her thesis titled Improving Developmental Monitoring Practices of Remote Australian Aboriginal Health Workers, the TRAC study, and Dr. Nicole Percival for her thesis titled Improving Health Promotion in Indigenous Primary Healthcare. Is a continuous quality improvement approach feasible? I'm honoured to be here and to witness the introduction of researchers who will make a real impact in Indigenous and global health. Chancellor, in my capacity as Director of the Menzies School of Health Research, I present to you for the degree of Graduate Diploma in Public Health, Sally Louise Granger. And for the degree of Master of Public Health, Giselle Rossini. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Menzies School of Health Research.
I now call upon the Deputy Vice-Chancellor, Professor Sharon Bell, to present the Doctor of Philosophy graduates.
Chancellor, in my capacity as Deputy Vice-Chancellor, I present to you the candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy. The Doctor of Philosophy, or PhD, is awarded on the basis of in-depth research conducted over an extended period of between 3 and 5 years, or in the case of part-time students, up to 10 years. The resulting research is assessed by a national and international panel of academic experts to determine whether the research makes a significant and original contribution to knowledge. The candidates today have met these demanding criteria. Chancellor, in my capacity as Deputy Vice-Chancellor, I present to you Abu Nasser Muhammad Abdullah. Abu Nasser Muhammad Abdullah holds a Master of Science from the University of Bremen, Germany, Master of Science from the University of Dhaka, and a Bachelor of Science from the University of Dhaka. For his thesis entitled Livelihood Strategies of People Surrounding the Sundarbans Mangrove Forest, as supervised by Dr. Natasha Stacey, I now present to you Dr. Abu Nasser Muhammad Abdullah. Gillian Ainsworth. Gillian Ainsworth holds a Master of Arts with honours from the University of Edinburgh, an Advanced Diploma in Export, Marketing and Languages from Napier University. For her thesis entitled Valuing Birds, Understanding the Relationship Between Social Values and the Conservation of Australian Threatened Avifauna, as supervised by Dr. Heather Aslan, I now present to you Dr. Gillian Ainsworth. Anita DiPrano. Anita DiPrano holds a Bachelor of Medicine from the University of Melbourne and a Bachelor of Surgery from the University of Melbourne. For her thesis entitled Improving Developmental Monitoring Practices of Remote Australian Aboriginal Health Workers, the TRAC study, as supervised by Professor Sven Silburn, I now present to you Dr. Anita DiPrano. Hannah Morrissey. Hannah Morrissey holds a Bachelor of Pharmaceutical Science from Tanta University in Egypt. For her thesis entitled New Roles for Health Professionals in Patient-Centered Healthcare Services in Rural and Remote Australia, Community Pharmacists Sharing the Responsibility for Chronic Disease Management, as supervised by Professor Patrick Ball, I now present to you Dr. Hannah Morrissey. Monishka Rita Narayan. Monishka Rita Narayan holds a Master of Science by Research from the University of South Pacific and a Bachelor of Science from the University of South Pacific. For her thesis entitled Design of Thin Film Organic Solar Cells for Optimum Performance, as supervised by Professor Jai Singh, I now present to you Dr. Monishka Rita Narayan. Nicole Ann Percival. Nicole Ann Percival holds a Master of Public Health from Queensland University of Technology and a Bachelor of Science from the University of Queensland. For her thesis entitled improving health promotion in Indigenous primary health care is a continuous quality improvement approach feasible, as supervised by Professor Ross Balin. I now present to you Dr. Nicole Ann Percival. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of the Doctor of Philosophy graduates.
I now call upon the Head of School Trades to present graduates from the Faculty of Vocational Education.
Chancellor, as the Head of School of Trades, it gives me great pleasure to welcome and congratulate the Vocational Education and Training graduates here today on behalf of the faculty. I would like to acknowledge the effort and commitment you as graduates have shown in completing your qualifications, and you should all be very proud of what you have achieved. I also extend my appreciation to those that have supported you in your training, whether it is your family, a partner, a friend, or a work colleague. My thanks also go to the lecturers, trainers, and administration staff at the university for the key role they have played in your training. Vocational education and training opens up so many opportunities for Territorians seeking access to first-time employment, a rewarding career path, workplace promotion, or personal and professional development. While the majority of our VET students undertake study for employment purposes, the attainment of a VET qualification also provides a pathway to higher level studies, with many VET students progressing into higher education courses. Also, our higher education graduates appreciate the practical employment aligned training that VET offers. I would encourage all of our graduates to consider further study and learning opportunities with Charles Darwin University, which is a dual sector institution, offers a seamless pathway from vocational education to higher education in many disciplines. Since the 1st of July this year, CDU has been able to offer students studying at diploma level the ability to defer any fees associated with the courses to the federal government's VET Fee Help Initiative. This is analogous to HECS in higher education, allowing students to defer fees for later payment. As well, we continue to offer the Northern Territory training entitlement to eligible Territorians, guaranteeing their ability to obtain a minimum of a Certificate 3 qualification if they do not have an equivalent qualification at present. So far this year, 50% of the training delivered to apprentices has been through the entitlement provision. At the recent 2014 Training Awards, CDU staff and students were well represented in the awards, winning six out of the seven categories, as well as the Training Initiative Award for a novel pre-apprentice program delivered in partnership with Group Training NT and the Department of Business. The individual winners will soon represent the Northern Territory at the National Training Awards. Investment in the training continues to be a priority for Charles Darwin University. Very soon, the waterfront building, located just behind you here, and which will house the School of Business, is on track to open for students at the beginning of 2015. At our Casuarina campus, the construction of our $28 million trade training facility is also progressing and will be available from early next year. In Alice Springs, refurbishment of the trades infrastructure to the tune of $4 million is also commencing. The investment in Alice Springs has come about in cooperation with the Catholic Education Office. In closing, again, I congratulate the graduates. Please enjoy this special occasion and celebrate your achievement in the company of friends and family. Thank you. Chancellor. In my capacity as Head of School of Trades, I present to you for the award of Certificate 1 in Automotive Vocational Preparation, Jack Crooks. Lachlan Sun. Nathan Turnbull. And Chancellor Callum Wilson. Certificate 1 in Spoken and Written English, Rita Kumari Mahasitha. Certificate 2 in Spoken and Written English, Daniela Ibasita. Chancellor Limbol Mangbando. Certificate 3 in Aged Care and Certificate 3 in Home and Community Care, Dione Wong. Certificate 3 in Cabinet Making, Mark Anthony Jackson. Certificate 3 in Carpentry, David Michael Jonas. Emmanuel Simeon. And Chancellor Gabriel John Peter Thorbjornsson. Certificate 3 in Children's Services, Matthew Burton Bradley. Heidi Elavira. Kongai Kim. Maria Jose Licardo. Cecile Mill. Selena Claudette Pope. Renu Rajesh. And Chancellor Lois Worcester. Certificate 3 in Electrotechnology, Electrician, David Andrew Needham. Certificate 3 in Heavy Commercial Vehicle Mechanical Technology and Certificate 3 in Mobile Plant Technology, Rolando Seguin Santos. Certificate 4 in Community Services Work, Charlie Yebara Damarindi. And Chancellor Glenn Eric Michael McCoy. Certificate 4 in Spoken and Written English, Madhamita Banerjee. Diploma of Horticulture, Regina Downs. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates from the Faculty of Vocational Education and Training.
I now welcome Mr. Michael Boldow, who will speak on behalf of the graduates.
Thank you for the chance. Chancellor, honored guests, teaching staff, family members, friends, fellow graduates, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the class of 2014, I'm very pleased to cheer in the excitement filling this convention center. As we today close the historic chapter of our lives. First and foremost, I would like to give thanks to our Chancellor, teaching and administrative staff for having put in much effort, energy, day and night to make us what we are today. Much appreciation goes to Dan Bashira, the course coordinator of the Bachelor of Humanitarian and Community Studies, for the tremendous work he had done on campus and on study field trip. Dan would wake us up early in the morning to tell us the political lessons. That would actually make the bush life of Matarankia enjoyable. Again, thanks goes to parents, guardians, and friends for the bare support you have given us along to make us accomplish this milestone achievement. Looking back at our academic journey, there are so many words that can describe the challenges that some of us went through. Some of us began with fresh and younger face, doubting how we would make it to high school and university, yet we made it up to this juncture. That some of us deferred studies due to the adequacy of tuition fee, as the parents could not afford to pay. Some of us, like myself, before coming to Australia 3 years ago, were challenged to survive the school life of refugee camp. A child would be learning one worried about what to eat when he or she comes back home. As a child would eat once a day until the following day. One would eat once a day due to the food scarcity, but some of us made it through to high school. I never thought I would make it to university and graduate like today. The school work had become increasingly harder, and each year seemed to be too difficult to survive through. But with perseverance, we succeeded. With the support rendered by teaching and administrative staff. In light of all the above mentioned challenges, persevering is the only word, I think, to describe how some of us came about to reach this momentum is bearing. Most importantly, we are armed with this keen knowledge that we have achieved so far. I can tell you we are prepared and excited to confront what lies ahead of us. Some of us will be heading straight to the workforce. Some of us have already chosen to have service in military. Therefore, with this screen and knowledge, let's go and fight poverty and injustice wherever in the world, so that our world becomes a better place where each and every person lives in a happy, free, just, and democratic society, where you pursue an opportunity in regardless of sex, religious, race, or age. Lastly, but not the least, we are feeling a great joy as this ceremony unfolds. We are seeing rocks and smile. I therefore ask you to take with us this enthusiasm that's thrown us today out into the world and use it to tell our achievements. As we move forward, let's not forget the friendship that we have cherished and some that we shall make along the way. Let's continue to care for ourselves, our families, friends, and our world. Thank you, and may God bless you all.
Thank you, Michael Boldale, for speaking on behalf of the graduates. Thank you for sharing with us your experience and the incredible challenges you had to face as a student in a refugee camp. And thank you for emphasising the importance of perseverance. Ladies and gentlemen, would you join with me again in thanking Mr. Michael Boldale? Graduates, congratulations to each and every one of you on your graduation from Charles Darwin University. Congratulations also to your family and friends who have supported you throughout your studies. The completion of your qualification is a great personal accomplishment and a source of joy to those close to you. I hope you reflect on the importance of this achievement as you leave this ceremony with testima in hand. Staff of the university are very proud of you and wish you well in your chosen career, and you leave the university as one of our special ambassadors. Now, as a proud alumnus of this university, I wish every one of you success and happiness. Thank you.
graduates, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of our ceremony. On behalf of the Chancellor and members of the University Council, I would like to now invite you to join the academic procession for light refreshments in the ground floor foyer, just that way outside the Garning Room. So would you now please stand and remain standing until the academic procession has departed. Thank you.